Stroh Hecker, and welcome to Closer to God, episode 122. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for leading and guiding us and directing us through this year of study in your word. And as we draw this year to a close, help us to be resolved in the new year to continue looking to your light, your truth, your wisdom, your way, your will, all as it's recorded in the Holy Bible, without allowing compromise for worldly passions or ideologies, but sticking to putting our trust in you and keeping to the truth of your holy word. For we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, I know it's kind of weird for me to be in the car again, but hey, you know, there's a lot going on in life. And even when life's schedule gets very, very busy, you need to take time for the Lord. And that's what we're doing here today. We're taking time for the Lord. And I want to read the next passage of the book of Acts, chapter 15, that we would be on for today. And it is at verse 22. And this is the council's letter to the Gentile believers. Remember, yesterday we talked about the whole discussion that was going on between the elders and the apostles and Paul and Barnabas, and these feelings about whether or not circumcision should be a prerequisite to becoming a member or follower of Jesus Christ's holy church in their time. So they debated it and they sought out God's guidance on this. And this is their response that they're sending back to the people that have raised this question or where this controversy exists. This is a letter back to them telling them, here's what we've discussed and here's what we've decided. So at verse 22, it reads, "The apostles and elders with the whole church decided to choose some of their own men and send them to Antioch with Paul and Barnabas. They chose Judas, called Barsabbas, and Silas, two men who were leaders among the brothers. With them they sent the following letter." And here's the letter. This is kind of cool because we're actually getting to read this letter ourselves because it's recorded in this book of Acts. "To the apostles and elders, your brothers, to the Gentile believers in Antioch, Syria, and Cilicia, greetings. We have heard that some went out from us without our authorization and disturbed you, troubling your minds by what they said. So we all agreed to choose some men and send them to you with our dear friends Barnabas and Paul, men who have risked their lives for the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, we are sending Judas and Silas to confirm by word of mouth what we are writing. It seemed good to the Holy Spirit and to us not to burden you with anything beyond the following requirements. You are to abstain from food sacrificed to idols, from blood, from the meat of strangled animals, and from sexual immorality. You will do well to avoid these things. Farewell." So in sending this letter, wow, the camera's kind of weird, sorry. Doing this in my car. Don't ask. You know, here they are. They sent this letter and they're brief to the point. And not only did they send the letter, they sent Judas and Silas, Judas and Silas, to confirm by word of mouth what's being said in the letter. So in other words, they're trying to make an impression upon them, look, these are not just merely words. These are the true feelings of the leaders after consulting God on this issue. And our decision, like we spoke about yesterday, is that you should not eat food sacrificed to idols. You need to abstain from blood and from the meat of strangled animals and from sexual immorality. These were all things that were prevalent in their society that were taking people's attention and focus off of God and place more on the religions of other gods and the worship of other gods that were in that area at that time. So they sent back in writing saying, look, this is what you need to abstain from. And notice they didn't say anything about the issue that sparked this controversy, and that is about circumcision. They did not want to entertain this anymore because they determined from God that this was nonsense. And this is something that was not something they needed to pursue, because it was more out of humanistic desires and wishes rather than what God's will was for the church. So that's what the reason why they omitted that from the letter, because they don't want to address it any further because it was placing a burden on the church at that time. What they wanted to focus on is, look, if you want to know what is the right thing to do at this time so that your focus remains on God and not on these extra things that we have seen that are taking your focus off of God, you need to stay away from these things in order to get everyone focused collectively on God, so they're not distracted by these other things. That's basically what they're saying here in this letter. And Judas and Silas and Paul and Barnabas are there to tell them and bear witness to this, that this is what they discern through the Holy Spirit from God as to how they're going to resolve this particular issue in the church. The men were sent off and went down to Antioch, where they gathered the church together and delivered the letter. The people read it and were glad for its encouraging message. Judas and Silas, who themselves were prophets, said much to encourage and strengthen the brothers. After spending some time there, they were sent off by the brothers with the blessing of peace to return to those who had sent them. But Paul and Barnabas remained in Antioch, where they and many others taught and preached the word of the Lord. So it's kind of interesting for us to get a little insight on how the early church functioned. And this is a great insight of and an example for us to follow in today's church, that look, we're here on God's behalf, not our own. And we're not here to serve our own desires. We're here to serve the living God. And that's what's important, even in today's church. And this is yet again a teaching from the Bible that directs us in that particular focus for the church. So happy new year to everyone out there. I hope that God will bring you many blessings in the new year. And I hope that we can spend more time together in the new year studying God's word together. So be careful. And enjoy some time with your family and understand and seek what God wants you to prioritize in the new year. Until then, remember, nothing in this world is more important than the love of Jesus Christ. I'll talk to you soon.